Cities are urban ecosystems. They are comprised of different networks, communication, transportation, electricity, sewage, water. The people who operate those systems and use those systems, and the interconnection between the systems. So a resilient city is a city that in the wake of a disaster, as a system, returns back to normal as closely as possible and as fast as possible. Damage to infrastructure is induced by earthquake effects. So ground shaking, ground deformation, landslides, liquefaction. The better we understand those phenomena, the better we can understand the impact of those effects on the infrastructure systems, and so we can learn how to build infrastructure systems that can withstand those effects in the future. Roads can be dislocated, especially when they're close to the fault. They can have debris fall over. They can be damaged because of a landslide that's deep-seated and takes the road along. Pipelines are also very susceptible. The water system, for example, of Los Angeles in many places is 100 years old, and those pipelines are made of cast iron and they are corroded. So it doesn't take a lot of shaking for those pipelines to break. Now, fiber optic cables, for example, are more flexible, but fiber optic cables also cross faults, especially in tectonically active areas like Southern California, and these can also break. Electricity cables are the same when the overhead transmission lines of electricity can fail because either the towers fall because of fault deformation or because of landsliding. Fires can be ignited, so we better have a fire station close by or means to transport water. But then if the water pipeline is broken and there's no water available to put the fire off, then that can cause larger problems downstream. And of course, roads that are being blocked or are being damaged don't allow police cars, fire engines, ambulances to go by. These effects are called cascading effects. So one system that's damaged causes the other system to the damage to be worse, and so on and so forth. And the larger the city and the more complex the infrastructure system, the more of those cascading effects can happen during an earthquake, and the more we have to think ahead in order to avoid them. Modeling earthquakes that are yet to happen and the effects of those earthquakes on our infrastructure systems as accurately as possible helps us both understand the risk and educate ourselves and prepare for future earthquakes. And that helps minimize the risk of a natural hazard turning into a disaster.